Hello everyone, and welcome back to the walkthrough. Let's start this room and meet a new kind of Deku Baba. This is a Baba Serpent, if I'm not mistaken. It looks like a normal Baba, right? Well, if you were to cut it, it still stays alive! That's why it's a Baba Serpent. So be wary when you try to attack that thing to know that it's gonna be coming after you. It's kind of funny if it latches onto you, though. It just kind of, like, gnaws at you painfully, but it just looks so silly how it is. I'm sure I'll be attacked by it eventually. And this is also a different kind of Baba, I guess. It is a Deku-like, I think it's called. It's like a like-like combined with a Deku Baba, because it's plant-like, I suppose. If you attempt to jump over it, it will suck you down and chew on you, and so you don't want that. You can't do anything about it until you get a bomb. And would you look at this? Just what I needed. So you've seen that other one over there, right? Let's throw it down in there. It eats it. This would be your fate if you were to jump across there. Since it explodes inside it, okay, that wouldn't exactly be your fate because you don't explode, you are not combustible in that way. Just saying. wait, which way should I go? Because it splits into four ways. Maybe I should go here first, just because I'm here. I forgot which one I wanted to do first, so I guess I'm just gonna randomly explore. Oh, this is a dead end. Well, actually, it's not a dead end. It's you come through here the other way, so it's like a way back. So, yeah, that's not the way I need to go just yet. Luckily, the enemies do not respawn when you leave a room in this Zelda. You have to leave the entire dungeon for that to happen. Oops. Well, that didn't work out well. I thought I could have made that jump. They don't do a lot of damage when they nibble on you, but it's still pretty funny to watch. Oh, and you see these leaves on the ground? Remember those as well. They actually do something, believe it or not. Than, you know, other than just making noise. Wait, you aren't helpful at all. I need to find a different one. I don't go that way. Yeah, I have to go this way. Grab it quickly. Jump. Go, 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 go. Jump. Throw. Ah! I think I made it. I don't think I took a hit there. No, I took a hit there. So you gotta blast that open. I think this just leads to... I know it's another dead end, but you have to go through here. Cutscene! Trapped monkey! Oh, poor monkey. Oh, and by the way, we're gonna have to come back into this room another time. You'll see why when I get to the other side. You see that? Well, that's not what I'm talking about. But you see these things? If you stand on one... It hurts you. Yeah, it's a trap kind of enemy. You can't do anything about them right now, but you can knock stuff off pillars. Well, totem poles. And get yourself a key! Yeah, just not wasting any time here, just getting that done right off the bat. That had me puzzled the first time I got through here, because I didn't notice that treasure chest up there before. Alright, so watch where those guys are and walk around them. There we go. And light the torch. Torches carefully. I did not pay attention at all. Alright, let's watch a little more carefully here. That raises that. Okay, you are there. And I'd like to go around the guys rather than going through the center. That's why I went like that, just to be safe. And I think there is a treasure chest off to the left side. Maybe. I think. If I were to climb this. Ah, no. No, the camera flipped on me and that's why I went over to the right. Just like at the beginning of the game when I kept climbing to the left on that first pillar. And I'd like to get some hearts just because I don't like the beeping. That's a good reason, right? Don't like the beeping, so get some hearts. Very motivational beeping. Eh, it's a red rupee. Nice. Okay, now that I got all these... Ow. All these platforms up by lighting the torches, I can go up here and free the monkey! I'm pretty sure that's all I can do at the moment here. Ah! Did not see that coming. You got her. Yeah, you're guarding my attacks. Come on. Lower your guard. Need to stab when you lower it. Come on.
There we go.
Voila. Sometimes I go a little crazy with the Wii Remote and keep swinging, which makes him keep swinging. Anyway, another monkey is saved. It is pleased. Extremely pleased. And I would like to... There we go. Just wanted to see if there's anything in there in those. I'm going to carefully make my way back and not get flinged into the abyss. Yeah, I don't think there's anything else around here at this moment. I'm going to have to come back through here anyway, so it doesn't really matter at the moment. So, yeah. Now I'm going to... Actually, over here. Kill these guys off, obviously. Otherwise, you won't be able to climb up it. It's easier to make that jump when you roll off the edge. It gives you a little more acceleration as you go over it. Oh, I can get this right away, too. If you pick this up and throw it down here. That one, the one that was chewing on me earlier, will now get its own thing to chew on and blow itself up. Own thing to chew on? What am I even saying today? I have no idea. Anyway, open this up, and you will find the heart piece! Yeah! That is awesome. Alright, let's go back up. And then through that door. Do-do-do-do-do. What? And... Wah! Such slow climbing in comparison to everything else. Alright, here we go. And we got sort of a mini-boss here. Why I say sort of is because it doesn't really do all that much. You'll see what I mean. There's a key. Well, I guess it picks up the key and eats it, if that is, like, considered eating it. I don't know. It seems to be, like, protecting it more than anything. So this is a giant Deku Baba or big Deku Baba, whatever they're called. I think it varies per game. You can't actually like attack it directly. Well, you can, but it doesn't hurt it. What you're supposed to do is bomb it. So grab one of these and throw it over there. Hopefully it'll get exploded. No, it did not. It takes a little bit of timing. This may take a few tries. That didn't work. There's also another one over here, if you want to keep alternating between the two to speed things up. Okay, throw it there, and... Okay, I think I have to lead it as it's about to explode, so that it gets low enough to be hit by the explosion. So I'm going to throw it at the edge, and then lead it here. Oh, I was a little bit early. I mean, the explosion was a little early. Okay, throw it. Now, come here. There we go. And one more. Or at least I don't think you can hurt it with your sword. Or you might be able to hit it with your sword, because I remember it's only taking one bomb before, so maybe hitting it with the sword does work. It just takes a lot longer than using bombs, maybe. And come on. Oh! Well, these bombs are clearly here for a reason, so... Come on. Quick. Yeah! Or maybe the bombs are for this thing, when it opens up like that. Well, you can kill it either way. Maybe you can kill it with your sword or with the bombs. You can definitely kill it with the bombs. But I think sword... I overshot it. I think the sword does damage it as well. It just takes a lot longer. There we go. Now give me the key! Boop. Ah, so beautiful. So shiny. Just look at it. Despite being in a gooey critter stomach, it still sheens And now it doesn't sheen anymore. I just had to point that out. The key looks so much shinier on the ground than it does when you're holding it, or when it comes out of a chest or something like that. I don't know why. Alright, let's move on. I don't think there's anything else here. But I think I do have enough monkeys. I need 4 monkeys to get across a bridge. I believe I can just jump down from here. Yes. Delightful. I'm back. Ow. Back to the main room. I got 4 monkeys, right? Yes, okay. I am good to go. Huh. Whoop. Follow the monkeys! They know what they're doing. They have been communicating to each other the whole time, and they know exactly how many monkeys they need to bridge this gap. Yeah, this is the place where that boss monkey, the boss of this monkey tribe here, cut down the bridge. Why is it acting so mean? Well, you're about to find out. Huh? Whoop! Yeah! Whoop! Voila! Dramatic roll! Now let's go up the stairs. Is anything... Well, that's for later. That's on my return trip. I don't need anything from there, so let's go through here and face off against the mini-boss of the dungeon, the real mini-boss. His name is Ook. Ah! That is an unflattering camera angle. Oh, poop! Obviously take care of those first. Hey! Be nice! Alright, Baba Serpents! Oh. One grabbed onto me. As I said, it looks really silly when they grab onto you and gnaw at you. Anyway, now, for this boss battle, you want him to throw his boomerang at you, and while it's being flung at you, roll into the pillar that he is standing on, and the boomerang will come back and knock him off while he is off balance, like so, and he will fall off the pillar. Attack his butt, because that is his weakness. Seriously. Maybe his butt is really sensitive, that's why it is so red. Oh, almost got it. That's okay. Just gotta time it a little bit better. Just keep watching him. It's better when you're actually at a distance than near him, because the boomerang comes back too quickly then. Yeah! Right between the cheeks! just keep repeating until he's finished off, and he'll occasionally knock some more of those serpents off the ceiling, but they aren't a hard enemy to deal with in the slightest. Come on, throw it. You can do it. It's not hard to dodge his boomerang, but it is kind of tricky to get the timing down to get him to hit himself with the boomerang. Like so. Oh, no, get off me! I want to hit him in the butt right away. It's over! And that's why he's been acting weird. He's had this bug on his head. Maybe it's like some sort of mind control bug or something like that. Run! And now he's afraid of me. It was a bug that was brainwashing him this whole time. And with his defeat, well, actually the bug's defeat, you get this. I am the Fairy of Winds who resides in this boomerang. You have freed me from evil, and I now have my true power back. Please, take it with you. Use it to aid your quest, and may both my power and my blessing go with you. If you focus power in your boomerang before releasing it, it will unleash the power of wind, aiding you in unforeseen ways. It is a boomerang that creates tornadoes, basically. Well, it has the power of wind in general, and you can use that for a variety of things. and it's telling you the controls right here, and you actually need that sort of to get out of here. Well, I suppose you could figure out the item on your own, but still, you get what I mean. remember that I was saying to remember these leaves on the ground? And why do I have the fishing rod selected of all things? Oops. You can now blow these leaves off the ground, and sometimes you'll get stuff underneath them, like hearts and rupees and maybe some Deku seeds or something like that. But anyway, what you want to do is turn the propeller. Three times, actually, I think it is. I think you have to lock onto it for it to be able to hit it. I'm going to try it without it. No, I can hit it without the lock on, I guess. And there you go. You are free. I don't think there's anything else in this room to mention. No, I guess not. So let's get out of here. I think the real prize here was just the boomerang and not the little leaves on the ground there. I don't think they really conceal anything. They're just stuff for like hearts and rupees and, you know, optional stuff essentially. Although I could be wrong, there's a patch or something that I'm going to have to flip over. Alright, now that I have this, remember that propeller in the other room? Yeah, these things are controlled by the power of wind, so flip it over. Whoa! I didn't mean to roll. I wanted to come out of the Z targeting mode, or B targeting mode, pardon me. Can I just, like, flip it right away? No, I can't. I have to wait until it dies down. There we go. Now, do not roll off the edge. Over here is yet another monkey, guarded by a very, very weak enemy. But it's up there. So what do you do about that, exactly? That. Voila. Wow. It's got some jumping power in those legs. Yep, gotta free all the monkeys in order to get through this dungeon. And I'm going the wrong way. Go over here and quickly get to the edge to be able to flip this over. No, wait! I did the roll again. Duh, what's wrong with me? And I'm back over here. Curses! Alright, let's try this again, shall we? Just flip one of them and roll across to the other one while you can so that it doesn't close on you. Otherwise, you're going to have to wait a while or you're going to have to flip it over manually. And remember I said that this path was a way back? Yep, just a handy little shortcut back to the lobby of sorts. So, that's all I think I'm going to be doing in this part. I will be continuing this dungeon in the next part. I hope you enjoyed. I'll see you then. Monkey swing! Woo!